Welcome to your 2022 weather wrap. It's January 1st. Sacramento has the second wettest start to the water year on record. Life is good until the tap goes dry. 5/100ths of an inch of rain in January. There's time to make it up. February is statistically the second wettest month of the year here. It turns out you probably remember February for weather whiplash rather than rainfall.
It was cold at first, got kind of used to it, and then it started to get warmer.
Back-to-back record highs are set on February 12th and 13th. 11 days later, a cold snap brings us consecutive record lows. Rain-wise, the month ties 2020 as the driest February on record with just a trace. Our dry streak continues into March. No measurable rain from January 7th to March 3rd. This is our longest wet season dry streak ever recorded at 54 days. The Sierra snowpack fades to 63% of normal on March 1st.
Then, a Hail Mary from Mother Nature. The National Weather Service issues a rare late-season winter storm warning on April 20th.
That's only happened 6 times in the past 10 years.
It threw me for a loop when I seen all the snow, because I said, like, I never seen this much snow anywhere.
It delivers. 1 to 3 feet of fresh snow. Sacramento hits 100 degrees for the first time on May 18th. The average first 100-degree day is June 11th. Summer officially begins on the 21st with a high of 105 in Sacramento, and 4 more 100-degree days in the month thrust us into fire season.
You can literally see the flames from our front porch.
The Rice's fire takes off in Nevada County on June 28th, burning 904 acres.
The heat hits harder in July. Downtown Sacramento has a 6-day heat wave with highs ranging from 100 to 106 degrees.
The Electra fire, Washburn fire, and Oak Fire each burn thousands of acres.
How is it that our place survived?
August will be remembered for the high heat and the deadly McKinney Fire.
I was afraid to die, honestly.
The fire claimed the lives of 4 long-term Siskiyou County residents. September then carries the torch of the scorch as a major heat wave hits on the 1st through the 9th of the month. 5 consecutive record highs are set at Sac Exec's weather station, ranging from 106 to 114 degrees. Sac City's weather station hit 116 on September 5th, making it the hottest temperature ever recorded there. Amidst the heat, California's largest wildfire of the year begins. The Mosquito Fire in Placer and El Dorado counties burns almost 77,000 acres, forcing evacuations.
Having to move from the first location, the evacuation center, that was so traumatizing.
October 1st marks the start of a new water year, but there's no water. The first rain comes November 1st with an underwhelming 0.14 inches. A modest 0.8 inches of rain falls in Sacramento on Election Day.
December has been good to us, but with another La Nina winter, history could repeat itself. Hopefully, the new year brings new water and we avoid a 4th consecutive year of drought. In Sacramento, I'm meteorologist Adam Epstein, Fox 40 News.